The tire is the contact between the car and the ground. Formula E looks all the same, but actually there are a few differences in each car. You have to study exactly how the suspension works. So can you tell us the difference between the different suspension you found out here?
So in fact, the Formula E, the car is the same for everybody. The body is the same. The front suspension is the same. But the manufacturer has developed specific powertrain. And the rear suspension also is specific to each manufacturer. That means that there can be some slight differences between all the cars. So as a result, we will have differences in the weight balance of each car and the rear suspension working. In terms of tire, that means that everybody has the same tire, the same Michelin tire. So this tire has to work for all the cars. And that means also that the teams can have different setups on each track, depending also on the design of the powertrain and the design of the rear suspension.
So this one is a tire that it's really wide as a user, because it's a front tire, it's a rear tire. You have to cope with different settings, different temperature, wet, dry. You have to cover almost every situation.
Exactly. That's exactly the philosophy of the Michelin Pilot Sport in Formula E. It's one type of tires for all drivers, all cars, all tracks, and all conditions. And what is also interesting, this season, we have introduced a new tire with improvements in all categories, in terms of grip, in terms of energy efficiency, in terms of weight. We have done three races until now. The first one, Riyadh, we got a lot of rain at the beginning of the day. So the tire had to run on rainy conditions, damp conditions, and drying conditions, and dry conditions. Then Marrakech, it started at 3 degrees on the track. And Santiago, the race was with 62 degrees on the track. So it has been a very interesting test for this new tire. And what we can say is that the result is really good. Everybody is really happy with the performance, but also that shows that the working window is really, really, really wide. And what is also very interesting and very positive is the fact that the car for this year, it's a new car with more performance. There's a gap in performance compared to last year, but we know that part of this gap is also due to the tire. So at the end, that means that the new tire is lighter, more efficient, and with more performance.
So you can cover almost every single different condition on this planet. And this is something that you can transfer to the production tire.
Exactly, and that's the reason why we are involved in competition and specifically in Formula E. It's to learn and to test new technologies inside the tires and to use this technology in the future on the street tires. And having such a philosophy of a unique tire for all conditions, it means that the link and the transfer could be very quick. On your car, you don't change the tire when it starts to rain or when it's warmer, except of the winter conditions, which need specific tires. But clearly, we are in a competition that makes sense, and for us, it's a very interesting laboratory.
And coming back to the drivers, you think that the drivers are already doing all the possible setting, or you think there's something that they will find out during the season?
What is also complicated in Formula E is the fact that it's one day event. That means that they have to do a lot of things in a very short time, because they have only two free practices with very small time. So doing the setup of the car, understanding the tire is clearly also take times. So they are doing a lot of simulation. That means also that it's important for them to have a tire that will work in every conditions with and that is very gentle with all the setup that we have on the car. So the behavior of the tire is very consistent, even if the setup of the car is could be different. And what is also a specific point on this race is the fact that tomorrow they will have a one-day test session that will give them the opportunity to perhaps do some more testing in terms of setups. But they have to always keep in mind that what is working in the track of Mexico could be a bad setup for a next race in Hong Kong. So it's important to extract what is, I would say, a main conclusion and what is specific to the Mexico track.
And talking about future race, drivers do a lot of training on the simulator. So you have to create an algorithm that simulates this tire. This was a very hard work, or you was already thinking the tire with also the computational model in mind?
Clearly for us the simulation is a very important tool, and we started to work on such topics since a long time, and by the way of competition, because it's important in competition to be quick, to react quickly, and the computer and the simulation is the best way to be quick. Also, it's an efficient way. It don't need to produce tires, to transport tires, so it's very also sustainable. So we have worked in the simulation tool since a long time. We have very strong models. That was probably one of the key of our success in developing the right tire in Formula E in 2013, because we started with nothing. There was no car, there was no track, only one drawing, and we had to develop the tire and to be ready for the first race. So simulation is clearly a key, and of course we have some tools and some models, and teams can have access to that.
Thank you.